Sublevel 3. Jules' team has found new pages written by Wake. He must have gotten Rudolph Lane painting again. His bullshit pedestrian methodology cannot produce results before mine. I have to go faster, no matter the cost. We're still behind our projections. The more the machines can produce, the closer we can calibrate them to Wake's style. But proper calibration takes a lot of raw material, and production is slow. No, no. We're changing directions. The hypothesis remains unchanged. Imitating Wake's writing style will allow us to generate art capable of linking with the threshold. Our live subject should match Wake's style much faster. People can be calibrated just like a machine. You simply have to push the right buttons.
Mm-hmm. Water dripped from the ceiling as Diana stared at the folders stacked on her workstation. Each one was a branch of research. Drip. Some were thin, some thick. They represented years of her life, her work, dissecting the act of creation and examining the bloody pieces. Bringing in live subjects had been her idea. Drip. Bureau leadership denied their request. But after HQ went into lockdown, she took advantage of the chaos and got her artists. Jules had whined about the optics. Diana ignored him. Now in her office below the waterline of Cauldron Lake, she considered how to proceed. Jules was convinced the page they had found would come true. It promised disaster. A situation out of control. Impossible. Diana was always in control. Drip. Drip. She needed answers. She needed to quantify, to define, to control.
Level 1.
Open it from the side. Bingo. That key card's gonna get me to sub-level 5. Thank you. opening the door.
Not very scientific. Came up with that. Shadow.
Comes to my lab and treats me like some kind of assistant. A putain d'assistant, moi? I run the lake house. This is my facility. Mine! He cannot just walk in here for 1 week, make some speeches, and then fly back to New York. Espèce de crétin, prétentieux! The jackass thinks he's a fucking rock star! And he made fun of the name. Huh. Oh, the shadow. The shadow is good. It's evocative. He is just a jealous, spoiled little child. And I will make it so everyone can see this. I will make it so no one even remembers his name! To see his imbecile là, hein? They all think I am a pencil pusher. They think I do not have the mind for such work. Eh bien, ils verront. Ils verront! I will take what they think is possible. And I will break it.
There was a crack in the lake house. The Marmonts had let the lake in, but the water could not flow. It became trapped, stagnant, went bad. The truth was controlled here. The art was not art, just content for the experiment. The contrived overlap rebounded on itself, compressing, compounding, reflecting and refracting. An urban legend and a murder in constant imbalance, cause and effect hopelessly entangled. Arranged wrong, the dream logic flawed. The feedback loop doubled and redoubled, out of control. The pressure kept building, looking for a release.
This should get me down to sub-level 5. And this should get me past any other problems. Nope. Damn it.
Works on these bastards.
Thank you.
The Shadow had changed Jules Mormont into a hostile, paranatural entity. That made everything simpler. No arrest, no paperwork. I could put him down like the monster he was.
Sublevel 3. Sublevel 2.
Lane was found dead in his cell this morning. It's an unfortunate setback.
when a door is closed, a window is opened. I believe that's the saying. Lane may be gone, but he left us with a goodbye present. A final piece of art. This piece is different. It's raw emotion, pure truth. He put everything he had into this one. Literally. Every reading we take is off the charts. This is what we have been waiting for. It is the key. I will achieve what no one has before me. Not darling, that arrogant shit. Not my selfish harpy of a wife.
So, we have a painter and a painting that can talk. Clearly connected. But Lane was dead before any of this even happened.
I never needed any of them. The fools will finally see me for the genius I am.
Jules Marmont looked at the painting.